Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Pepsi Stadium.
Hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Pepsi Stadium here on the campus of North Greenville University. Tonight, we have a Conference Carolinas matchup to bring you, featuring the Limestone Saints versus the home North Greenville Crusaders. Both of these teams coming off impressive wins just last week in their openers. Limestone took down Belmont Abbey 3-0, and North Greenville also had a shutout last week, taking down Georgia Southwestern State 2-0. So both of these teams coming in here without giving a goal.
At defense, number 12, Alexander Rinder. At midfield, number 13, Jacob Hancock. And at defense, number 15,
we'll go ahead and go over the starting lineup first for the Limestone Saints.
Mark Radoki.
In goal is going to be number zero. Correction, number one, Johan Hipper. Number two is going to be Stefan Ruby. Number three at defender is Andres Cabrenes. Number six at midfield, Florin Fromholzer. Correction, I was actually reading the starters for North Greenville and getting the numbers mixed up. I'll go ahead and redo that for you real quick. In goal, number one is going to be Johan Hipper. Number two is going to be Stefan Ruby. Number three at defender is going to be Andres Cabrenes. Number seven at midfield is Tristan DeLaff. Number eight at midfield is going to be Pascal Verba. And at forward is going to be number nine, Angelo Fabricio. And at midfield, number 10 is going to be Antonio Ferreira. At defender, number 12, Alexander Render. At 13, another midfielder, Jacob Hancock. And number 15, a defender, S.J. Dressler. And last but not least, another forward, number 16, Mark Radoki. And that completes the starting lineup for the Limestone Saints.
Redshirt junior from Greenville, South Carolina, number 23, Gage Acker. At midfield, a redshirt freshman.
As mentioned earlier, Limestone posted three goals last week against Belmont Abbey. The goal scorers for your Saints were Angelo Fabricio, Mark Radoki, and Antonio Ferreira. So those are definitely three players to look out for on offense for Limestone.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, if you are able, we ask that you please rise and remove your caps for the invocation and remain standing as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for today. Thank you for the great sport of soccer. We ask that you bless this game this evening. Give each of the players here.
For your surprisingly great rates, contact your local State Farm agent today.
If you want the real deal, call State Farm agent Tiffany Friel in Landrum today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hello and welcome back to Pepsi Stadium, where we have men's soccer action to bring to you between the Saints of Limestone and the Crusaders of North Greenville. Previously, before break, we went over Limestone's starting lineup, and now we're going to go ahead and take it over to North Greenville's starting lineup. For you, in goal, Reno Vandermeer, number zero, gave up 0 goals last week against Georgia Southwestern State. At midfield, number two, Bradley Jennings. At defense, number three, Cade McLaughlin. And at midfield, number six, Arthur Leary. At forward, number seven, Louise Netto. Another midfielder, number 17, Connor Hall. Another forward, number 11, Calvin Semedo. Number 23, another forward, Gage Aker. And another midfielder, number 24, Angel Miranda. Another midfielder, number 20, Louise Lazama. And another midfielder, number 31, Arthur Santana. The two goal scorers for the Crusaders in their last week's game against Georgia Southwestern State were Louise Lazama and Calvin Semedo. So definitely look out for those two players here tonight. And obviously it's going to be very interesting between these two goalkeepers. Neither one of them has given up a goal this year. And that being said, they've only played one game, but both of them posted clean sheets. Jonathan Hipper had four saves last week. And for the Crusaders, Reno Vandermeer had 8 saves. And here we go. We are underway live again. The Crusaders in red versus the Saints in blue. And the Crusaders will control it and pass back to their own third as they look to set something up here early in this game. It looks like the pass is going to be deflected out of bounds. North Greenville will retain possession. Looking for the attackers, looking for number 11. They're unable to hook up, and Limestone's going to take over. Hipper passes back to their defender as they launch a big pass into the midfield. Controlled by the midfield, still by Limestone. And it looks like we're going to have our first foul of the game. We'll see who they call that on. Limestone will retain possession. Slowly moving it towards the midfield, and an errant pass from number three, that's Combrenas, and that's going to be a turnover and a foul against the Limestone Saints. Looks like we have a player shaken up here. And that looks like number six, Arthur Leary, but he gets back up on his feet and seems to be okay. So already in this game, each team with a foul. And it's gonna be a yellow card against Limestone. That's gonna be on number 10, Antonio Ferreira, who is the guilty party. North Greenville will get a free kick here. And it looks like it's gonna be taken by Bradley Jennings, a defender for North Greenville. As he surveys his options, hoofs it to the left side of the field, but it is intercepted by Limestone as they look to counter, but it quickly falls apart. over to the top of the screen. The Crusaders in control of it. And it looks like the ball is just going to go out of bounds, and Limestone will get possession back. So far early, neither team either to establish possession. Still with the Limestone defenders. As they're playing fairly high. And North Greenville is able to win it back. But pressure from Limestone forces the ball out of bounds. But North Greenville will keep possession. North Greenville taking their time with this throw-in. And they keep hugging the left side of the field at the top of the screen. Let's see who comes away with it. And it looks like it's going to be number 11 for North Greenville. That's Calvin Semedo. And North Greenville loses the ball out of bounds. Limestone takes back over. Again, Limestone passing back to their defenders. Number 15, Ethan Thompson, who passes it over to his defender counterpart, number 12, Michael Lamb. Lamb back over to Thompson. And looking for the long ball. It is not there, broken up, but one right back. And again, it looks like early on, Limestone is looking to go to those long balls over the top to see if they can't use their speed on the wings to get through the North Greenville defense. There we go, NGU! And here we go. Another throw in for North Greenville. Again, towards the top of your screen. Back over to Andreas Cabrenas, and he passes up to the midfield. Again with a through ball, a great pass from number 10, Antonio Ferreira, and they are able to keep possession. And it's a cross inside. It was an excellent pass by number 7, Tristan DeLaff. However, a Saint is not able to get on the end of that ball, and it rolls out of bounds. That was definitely our first half chance of the game. North Greenville able to maintain that clean sheet. And Limestone intent on putting pressure on these North Greenville attackers. They are unable to get any sort of possession here early as Limestone looks to just possess the ball in their back third and just look over the top for those long balls. And that's going to be another foul against North Greenville. It looks like number 10, Antonio Ferreira, drawed the foul. And that's going to go against number 6, Arthur Leary. And it's quickly taken by Limestone. And Andreas Cabrenas with an errant pass that is deflected. However, Limestone maintains possession. And it's a through ball over the top. Another interesting, curious pass from number 10, Antonio Ferreira. Number 7, Tristan DeLaff is just unable to get on the end of that. But good action so far here from Limestone. You definitely feel a Limestone goal coming on here. They've had two half chances to North Greenville's nothing. the pass is going to be deflected out of bounds. North Greenville will get it back. The throw in is taken quickly, looking for Samedo. It's not there. And Limestone will steal it right back. And the ball is kicked out of bounds by Angelo Fabricio. The throw in is taken by McLaughlin. And it is taken quickly back by Limestone. Excellent pass from Dressler. And the Limestone defenders have been showing great promise with the long balls over the top. However, just nobody able to get on the end of them for the Saints. And we'll have a free kick coming up here for North Greenville. And it is headed away and taken back by Limestone, and they're going to be content to pass it back to their defenders, back to 15, Dressler, who swings it over to his counterpart, number 12, Render. Here we go, the Saints looking to get into the attacking third. They're unable to. And we're gonna have another Greenville foul. That's gonna go against Calvin Samedo. And the free kick taken quickly by Limestone as they again possess the ball with their defenders. And it's an excellent touch pass. And it's a whiffed clearance by number 24 from North Greenville, Angel Miranda. And it left an opening for Limestone. However, they're unable to get a foot to it. And it rolls safely to Vandermeer. And the pressure again mounting. Here we go, Limestone again on the attack. And the ball is just deflected by a North Greenville defender. It was a nice move from Radoki. However, he is unable to get anything on target there. Back to Dressler, who moves it over. And it's cleared away by North Greenville. It looked like Arthur Santana was gonna try and get in there and sneak a steal, but he is unable to, not quite quick enough. And here comes the Saints the other way. The ball rolls out of bounds. It looks like we're gonna have our first corner kick of the game. And we'll see who takes it for Limestone. And it looks like we're gonna see Antonio Ferreira take this corner. And it looks like we have another whistle from the ref. They seem to be arguing with what looks like Hancock. Looks like he's getting in the way of the goalkeeper, but they finally resume play, and it's an errant header that is picked up by Reno Vandermeer, and North Greenville will get a chance for some offense. The Still no shots on goal in this game. We do have, however, three shots from Limestone, none of them on goal. And North Greenville just looks a little bit out of sorts here early on, as the pressure from Limestone certainly is furious. But it's a ball over the top, trying to get it to their speedster, Semedo. He is unable to get to it. It's an interesting and curious pass there. It was a good idea, just couldn't quite get on the end of it, and it'll be back with the Saints. And it looks like a whiffed pass. North Greenville almost with a steal, and could have been dangerous there. Dressler sort of fell asleep on that pass. And again, Dressler over the top with the long ball. It's received by Cabrenas, who passes to DeLaff. Back to Cabrenas. He passes it in. Still dribbling in the box. And it's going to be passed back to midfield. Limestone still in possession. Definitely threatening here. And it's picked away by Angel. And North Greenville is going to get the ball back. Here we go, the forward for North Greenville. Calvin Semedo looking to make a move. And it was a dangerous tackle from number 12, Alexander Render. And it looks like he's going to get away without a foul. Definitely a dangerous tackle, but it works out in the end. Perfectly executed, and North Greenville's going to get their first corner of the game. And that's definitely the danger man for North Greenville. Semedo scored a goal in North Greenville's season opener last week. Almost added to his total there. And it's a long kick to the feet of Semedo over everyone's head. And he gets picked. And here comes Limestone with a counterattack. They hoof it upfield, but it is Reno Vandermeer coming way out of his goal to boot that one safely out of bounds. And here we go. Cabrenas to throw in. Taken quickly. And back to the feet of the Limestone defenders. It's a through ball attempt, and it is plucked away by Reno Vandermeer. That's definitely not the first time we've seen Antonio Ferreira with one of those through balls. But so far, North Greenville is up to the task, and they have kept a clean sheet. And we have a North Greenville player down. It looks like it's Semedo. He appears to be all right as he is helped up by a teammate. That's Arthur Santana. Both of these teams with such great speed on the outside. They're just looking to find something over the top to where they can penetrate the defense, but not much in it so far. Here comes Limestone trying to win a corner, and they are unable to. They'll actually lose possession. That's number 16, Mark Radoki, who loses possession. And it looks like it's going to be taken by Angel Miranda, who tosses it in. And here comes Limestone. They have numbers. Can they put a couple passes together? It's crossed in. Radoki's cross is deflected and pushed out of bounds. We're going to get another Limestone corner. And once again, it's going to be taken by Antonio Ferreira. It's taken short. Whipped in the middle, and again headed away by North Greenville. We're going to get another corner from Limestone. Take a look at number 13 in the goal for Limestone. It looks like he's just playing games with the goalkeeper right now. That's Jacob Hancock, trying to get under Reno Vandermeer's skin. It looks a bit curious for sure. Again, taking short on the ground. And it's a shot from Limestone. That's Pascal Verba, who hoofs it out of bounds. But it looks like it took a deflection off a Greenville defender. And we're going to get another Limestone corner. S.J. Dressler, the tallest player on the pitch, 6'4". Number 15 standing there in the middle. Let's see if they can't find him. And it's at the feet of a Limestone attacker, and it is cleared away by North Greenville. But they do come up with possession and then quickly lose it. Limestone, again, seems to be sort of dominating possession here early in the first 20 minutes or so. North Greenville still with no shots posted. So far it's been Limestone with all of the opportunities. Four shots, one on goal. And we're gonna get a stoppage in play here. That last shot by Limestone, taken by Pascal Verba. You feel like he could have done just a little bit better there. It was just a little bit too high and too far outside. Here we go. Limestone once again kicks it back into play, and they'll have possession in the midfield. And here we go. Swung back over to number three. That's Cabrenas. He looks to dribble ahead. Nothing doing. Going to pass it back out to the midfield, and again, sort of killing North Greenville with these midfield passes. And it seems like all North Greenville can do right now is just clear the ball away. But you have to say, so far it is working for them. They're definitely looking to draw in Limestone's attackers and try and find something on the counter. Nothing's been there for them, but Limestone have to be careful. North Greenville have plenty of speed on the wings at any given counterattack. And it looks like we're going to get a goal kick here from Vandermeer, who just takes it short to a fellow defender. Miranda. And a bit of possession in the midfield for North Greenville. Let's see. And it's a sliding tackle that came from Ferreira. Pushes it out of bounds, and North Greenville's going to take it right at midfield. Once again, another throw-in. North Greenville slowly creeping and inching it up the field with throw-ins. And here we go. It's taken. Tried to get it to Semedo. It's unable to get a touch to it, and it's cleared away, and Limestone will take over. And it's a nice ball over the top. That's Angelo Fabricio with the pass over the top, and the cross unsuccessful. Not even a Greenville defender able to get to it, and misses just about everybody. Still very dangerous though. North Greenville have to be careful. It's feeling like the pressure from Limestone is giving them plenty of opportunities, and we have another Greenville player down on the ground. You don't want to speculate too much, but it looks like he's cramping up here. And down on the ground, that's number 24, Angel Miranda, a central defender for North Greenville. And out comes the trainers, and the players are going to huddle up and talk about things here with just 22 minutes to go in this first half. Earlier today, there was calls for thunderstorms and rain, but however, we have yet to see anything of the sort so far today, thankfully, and we do hope that that continues and that there will be no delays in this game. We'll see who North Greenville elects to bring on the pitch, because it does look like they're going to bring off Angel Miranda. And Limestone's had a lot of success, you know, getting the ball up the wings with just balls over the top. But nothing going once they cross it in. You just feel like they're one or two more passes away from finding the back of the net. And Greenville have to be strong here in these last 22 minutes. And there you see Miranda being taken off the field by a trainer. We do hope that he is okay. Miranda's had a couple key clearances here in this game that has gotten North Greenville out of danger. You hate to see him leave if you're a North Greenville fan. And it looks like they're bringing on number 9, Christopher Holscher. Holster is a grad student, a transfer from Norman, Germany. We'll see how he fares on defense, and play is once again underway. The ball is taken by Reno Vandermeer, who blasts it to midfield. And quickly again, another foul. That one's going to be against North Greenville, so we'll see if Limestone can set something up here with this free kick. They take it short, take it back over to 15. That's Dressler, who looks to get it over to his teammate Cabranas. To the left wing, and it's looked like he was trying to cross it. However, it was a shot that went on goal. It needed saving by Reno Vandermeer. That's Tristan DeLaff with the shot. Had a bit of curve to it, but Vandermeer did well to catch it with both hands. And again, with a long ball from North Greenville, is there anyone on the end of it for them? There is not. It is taken by their goalkeeper, Johan Hipper. Johan Hipper hasn't had to do much today. But he must always remain ready. You never know with this North Greenville counterattack. So far it hasn't happened, but they must stay vigilant. And here we go, the long pass from the Saints rolls to the feet of Vandermeer. You just feel like Limestone needs to be a bit more patient. They have the possession, but it just seems to fade once they get into the attacking third. And how about this? A stray ball. Number 7, Tristan DeLaff, hustles over to it, is the first to make contact with it. And North Greenville defenders just look like they fell asleep there, and they're lucky it didn't make them pay for it, because DeLaff almost got on the end of that, almost found the back of the net. It looked like both defenders for North Greenville got caught just ball watching a little bit. Bradley Jennings passes it back to his goalie, and he receives it back from his goalie, and still, again, North Greenville looking for something over the top. It is not there. Not a lot of midfield possession for either team. Both teams looking to just kick it deep. Here comes North Greenville, an excellent give and go. There's a little bit of space at the top of the screen. Shaking off defenders. It's a shot, but it is deflected. And that was number 9, the substitute that just came on, Christopher Holscher. It was an excellent move. But he is unable to finish it. Limestone's defense, the one time North Greenville had an opportunity, they stayed strong, stayed together. Looked like that was North Greenville's first shot of the day. North Greenville will keep possession though, however. Looking to explore the midfield a little bit towards the top of the screen, and the ball once again finds its way into touch. North Greenville would feel pretty good about themselves the way they've been playing if they can get into the half 0-0. You kind of feel like the Saints are the favorites right now, but anything can happen. Wait, North Greenville looking to get something going here. And they do not. It is taken away by number seven. That's Tristan DeLaff. And it's a slide tackle from North Greenville. Looks like we're going to get a foul. It was not clean. It looks like it just clipped the heel of Antonio Ferreira. And I believe the foul is going to go against North Greenville. It is. I couldn't quite see who was on, but the free kick nonetheless is taken by the Saints. Long ball over the top. And here we go, a chance. And it's going to be a goal for Limestone. But do we have a whistle? We do. The goal will not count. The whistle was blown first. It looks like we have a striker for Limestone on the ground. That's number seven. That's Tristan DeLaff. It was an excellent move by Angelo Fabricio. Take a look here with the shot fake, spin, moves back the other way. But you see there at the right of your screen, a Limestone player is on the ground and the whistle's blown. And you got to think that's tough for Limestone in two ways. They have a player injured and the goal didn't even count for them. You just feel like North Greenville is just hanging on by a thread right now. And that's something that Angelo Fabricio can certainly do. He's definitely a goal scorer. He did score last week against Belmont Abbey. He also capped an assist in that game. Here we go. It's going to be North Greenville's goal kick. Vandermeer blasts it to midfield. Again, another clearance from Greenville. And it trickles into the hands of a Johan Hipper. Long ball over the top again. Looking for DeLaff. It was an excellent pass. That's Dressler. He's done that several times today. And DeLaff is just unable to get behind North Greenville. And it looks like we're actually going to get an offsides on DeLaff. Over the top, a long ball. North Greenville handles it safely. Bradley Jennings for North Greenville has just looked a little bit out of sorts on a couple of plays, but he's done well enough to keep them off the scoreboard. But you have to think, if you're Limestone, you keep going after DeLaff against Bradley Jennings, because a couple of times he's been caught ball watching and has just let a couple of Limestone attackers slip right by him. And as we're here in the last third of this first half, North Greenville just has to keep looking for the counterattacks, because there's been a little bit of hope for them there, but that's just about it. It is cleared away by Greenville. And here we go, looking to get something on the right side of the pitch. It's Semedo with a shot on target. And I think Johan Hipper might have thought that Semedo was going to cross it. However, he shot it. Hipper did well there to just push it out of bounds. But there you see the counter-attacking ability of North Greenville. Just like that, Semedo can just bolt down the sideline. This is Semedo's first year at North Greenville. He's from Paris, France. And we're going to get another corner kick for Greenville. And it goes over the heads of everyone, and it's taken back to the midfield. And then we're going to get a foul against Limestone. Semedo tried to box out Angelo Fabricio. And he draws the foul. And it's a great job here by Semedo, because if he lets Fabricio get that ball, Limestone could be going the other way looking for a goal-scoring opportunity, but he draws the foul. And instead of Limestone getting an opportunity, it's the Crusaders with a free kick. And it's good contact by North Greenville. Just too easy of a save for Johan Hipper. It looked like that was Luis Lezama on the end of that. Good contact, just not quite enough pace. And here comes Limestone. Limestone looking to carve up this defense. It's a shot taken but blocked. Again, that's going to be Bradley Jennings with a deflection. However, it falls to the Saints. They will keep possession. Excellent tiptoe passing here from the Saints. And it's a great move. Can they get a shot off? They cannot. That's Fabricio looking for the cross. Radoki unable to get on the end of it. But it will result in a Saints corner. And again, Ferreira is going to take this one. Mark Radoki with not a lot of opportunities so far in this game. He was another goal scorer for the Saints in their last week's game. So far for Limestone, it's been DeLaff and Dressler hooking up on long passes that have been the majority of their opportunities. And here comes the corner, and it's going to get blown dead. And it looks like we're going to have a foul on a Limestone player, and North Greenville will gladly take the goal kick. And here we go. Can North Greenville find a little bit of possession here in these last 10 minutes? Cleared once again. Limestone trying to work that right side of the field, the top of the screen. It just rolls out of bounds. It's a little bit of an errant pass from Radoki. And here comes the throw for the Crusaders. Bit of footsie going on the top of the screen. It looks like it's going to result in yet another North Greenville clearance. North Greenville has held up defensively. They've looked a little bit lost, and they've gotten caught ball watching a couple times. But besides that, they've done a great job of just clearing the ball and doing anything that they can to just loft it to their forwards. Throw-in is going to get awarded to North Greenville. Let's see who comes away with this one. and it's going to be Limestone. They have the ball at North Greenville's third. A pass over the top is going to be cleared once again. Can North Greenville counter here? Semedo looking for the ball, unable to get there quick enough. It is passed back to Johan Hipper, who moves it out to the left back, Cabrenas. Cabrenas. Here's Dressler moving it over top of the screen. Instead of going over the top, they look like they just gonna try and go around this defense. And it looks like Limestone is gonna get awarded a corner here. And it will certainly be taken by Ferreira. Limestone hasn't had a lot of success on these corners. They've taken six of them. None of them have resulted in shots on target. This one is whipped in by Ferreira, and it is met by a defender, but tapped back out. Ferreira looking again to cross it. It is scooped up by Vandermeer. We have just 7.5 remaining here in the first half. Bradley Jennings looks for Semedo. Does he have the speed? And we're going to get a whistle here from the official. Let's see what he calls. Again, that's number 11, Semedo, giving Limestone defenders issues with his speed. The only thing Dressler could do here is just drag him down, basically. You just look at that closing speed, and all Dressler can do is just stick his arm out and trip him up. It looks like we're going to get a free kick here in a dangerous position. Certainly an excellent opportunity for Greenville. We'll have to see who's planning on taking this one. Lizama was a goal scorer last week for the Crusaders. Let's see if he takes this one. Right now, the ball is in Arthur Santana's hands. It looks like he's conversing with Lizama. Definitely a dangerous position here. Mark Radoki almost looks like he's trying to steal this play call from North Greenville. And he finally exits the huddle, and it is going to be Luis Lizama who stands over it. Nope, and again, still conversation between the two North Greenville strikers. Mark Radoki being a little bit petty here. And that's sort of been the theme here today, is Limestone's just been sort of pestering all game long. And that's Mark Radoki. And here we go. It looks like it's going to be Lizama who takes it. It was a good shot just saved by Johan Hipper. And crisis avoided for Limestone as they finally get possession back after the long stall. And that was really the first time we've seen North Greenville look dangerous. That's Lazama's second shot on goal. He had one earlier, the header on a free kick that was unable to connect with the goal. And here we go, Limestone with a through ball. It is met by Vandermeer. Just a little too much heat on that pass coming from Josiah Ortiz. North Greenville will do well to clear it, but they lose it in the midfield. And that's something you certainly can't do if you're North Greenville. Quickly the other way come the Saints. That's just been an issue all day for Greenville, just losing the ball in the midfield. The shot here is going to be deflected by Greenville, and they're going to get another corner kick. You look at here, gets the ball over to number three, that's Cabrenes. Looks for a shot, and it's pretty safely deflected away. That's Bradley Jennings again, saving the day for Greenville. Not a very good corner taken, but it still somehow ends up in the Saints' feet. Crossed in again. This time it was taken by Pascal Verba. The cross, unable to connect, but they do maintain possession. Fancy footwork here from Limestone, and a through ball from Ferreira, unable to connect with a striker. Again, the attack relentless from the Saints. That's Ortiz. Can he find the back of the net? No, he is picked away. And here we go, North Greenville again on the counter. We've seen this today. This is where North Greenville has been at their best. It's Semedo looking to whip it in, and it is going to go behind the goal for a goal kick. Johan Hipper quickly takes it. No delay there from Johan Hipper, wanting to keep this pace of game going. And you can see why. Limestone has just been relentless in the attack, and you feel like they've almost deserved a goal here, and it would be a bit of a disappointment for them if they went into the half with nothing to show for it. It's to Cabrenes. Passes to Ortiz. And it's an errant pass that goes out of bounds. And we'll get another free kick from Vandermeer. As you can see, North Greenville, complete opposite. They're taking their time, slowly moving the ball up, just trying to get into the half with no damage done on the scoreboard. And here we go, there's a little bit of space here for number nine. That's Christopher Holscher. He is unable to find anyone on any of that cross. The dangerous play there from Greenville, Johan Holscher. Just unable to link up in the attacking third. But it definitely gave Limestone something to think about. Dressler has been playing high all game long. And there you see him with a long pass. One of those defenders for Limestone that just has been caught over the top a couple times with the speed of North Greenville. And that time he doesn't have to pay the price. Here's Render, moves it over to the right side for the Saints. And the ball is deflected out of bounds. And it looks like the throw-in will be taken by Stefan Ruby. Quickly passes it in, and it's a shot. Not quite on target, but how about the heads-up play from Stefan Ruby to quickly pass that ball in. And North Greenville really has to be careful here in these last 2 minutes. They can't fall asleep at the wheel now, like they just did. And they're gonna be content to get it back to Vandermeer. Greenville almost looked like they just want to possess these last 2 minutes and then go into the locker room and assess. Not a lot of ambition in this attack for North Greenville. They just content to keep it in their own third. And here we go. They lull them to sleep, and then over the top. It's a great pass. Unfortunately, the cross from number 23, Gage Aker, is unable to be connected with anything. And it is cleared away out of bounds. I think that's the first time we've called Gage Akers' name today. He's a redshirt junior from Greenville, South Carolina. And that time was not a great cross from Gage, but to be fair, there was no one on the end of it. But nevertheless, the Saints will keep the ball. It is with Ferreira. He looks, finds a pass, and wouldn't you believe it, in the last minute of this half, the North Greenville defense is exposed, and it is a goal from number 21, Thomas Mueller.
Goal, Limestone, number 21.
Unbelievable
Thomas
finish from
Mueller.
Him, and how about the pass from Ferreira? Take another look here. The pass from Ferreira looked like it was intended for number 13, Jacob Hancock. Hancock never even got a foot to it. The ball is deflected by North Greenville, and it just finds Thomas Mueller. North Greenville really have to be kicking themselves after that one. We said just about a minute and a half ago, they were so close to getting to the locker room, and here you see them just fall asleep at the wheel, and they give up a goal, the first of the game. And that's certainly going to be a topic of discussion for the North Greenville coaches at halftime. What are they going to do about this physical, aggressive Limestone attack?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
Here we go, last kick of the game. Can they get another shot off? It was an ambitious effort, but one that needed to be had with the clock running out. The shot is out of bounds, and that concludes our first half. Limestone just nicking a goal with 30 seconds left in the first half. Excellent first half from both teams. We'll take a break. Come back soon with second half adjustments. Thank you very much for joining us.
And as a reminder, no spectators are allowed on the field at any point during today's match.
Surprisingly great rates? Contact your local State Farm agent today.
If you want the real deal, call State Farm agent Tiffany Friel in Landrum today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Formally extend my gratitude for the Russell rate on my insurance.
Do you mean surprisingly great rates from State Farm?
I don't believe in accepting help, but I'll make an exception.
Here's the deal, Russell. There's no special rate. These prices are for everyone.
Consider us square.
I made that from memory. I know your face that well.
For your surprisingly great home and auto rate, call State Farm agent Tiffany Friel in the Foothills area today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Pepsi Stadium here on the campus of North Greenville University. Your first half score, the Limestone Saints 1, North Greenville Crusaders 0. Let's go ahead and take a look at the first half stat line. So far we have 11 total shots for Limestone compared to just 3 for North Greenville. So definitely the majority of attacking coming from Limestone. Fouls so far are barely even, 6 for North Greenville, 5 for Limestone. Limestone have been caught offsides twice. North Greenville has yet to be offsides. In the saves category, the goalkeeper for North Greenville, Vandermeer, has posted 3 saves so far compared to just 2 saves for the Limestone keeper, Johan Hipper. And for North Greenville, you have to ask, when are we going to see them sort of possess the ball in the midfield? We've yet to really see any thorough control from North Greenville. We've seen a lot of big balls over the top, trying to attack the wings, trying to get the ball to their speedsters. But will they be able to sort of manage the midfield a little bit better in the second half? For Limestone, you have to ask the question. You have to wonder what they're going to do, because the majority of this game, they've been, you know, pedal to the metal. They have been by far the more attacking side. They've had more opportunities. They've pressured North Greenville anytime that they've turned the ball over. And you have to wonder if they're going to continue that in the second half. You know, usually I'm a big fan and a big proponent of continuing what you're doing. If it's not broke, don't fix it. But in this case, you sort of feel like North Greenville's chances, the majority of their chances, come from counterattacks and times when Limestone has been too aggressive and they've brought their defenders too far forward. So you kind of feel like if Limestone just plays a little bit of possession here and a little bit defensively, North Greenville will really struggle to find sort of any offensive ebb and flow. Because right now, the only bright spot for North Greenville comes from the winger, Calvin Semedo. He's an absolute speedster, and he's had a couple of chances on counterattacks. So like I said, it'll be interesting to see how Limestone elects to play this second half. Here we are underway. North Greenville have just 45 minutes to make up for the 1-0 deficit. And quickly, early on here, it's a big ball over the top. The Saints still in possession, working that left side of the field, top of the screen. The ball is deflected out of bounds, and early on, Limestone look like they are going to be the aggressors. They are awarded a corner kick. And if you're North Greenville, you can't just rely on speed and speed alone. You have to find a way to link up in the attacking third. There's really been no one on the end of their crosses so far today, as that corner kick from Ferreira's gonna go over the bar. But yeah, like I said, not much offense from North Greenville. It'll be interesting to see if they can't sort of control the ball a little bit better. And here we see Limestone pressuring all the way up to the goalkeeper, and they are unable to keep it. And here we go, North Greenville with a chance. And it looked like Limestone might have gotten away with a little bit of a foul there, but the ref says play on, and Limestone again answering my question. Looks like they're going to go all out and continue to press. Number 9, Angelo Fabricio at the top, putting a lot of pressure on North Greenville's defenders. I would definitely like to see a little bit more control in the midfield for both teams. Both teams sort of have the strategy of just hoofing it downfield and going for the long ball, big ball over the top, but Here we finally see Limestone dink and dunk it up the field. They get it out to their left winger. Is there anyone on the end of this cross? There is not. And it looked like that was almost a shot coming from the left side. I should mention we've had a couple of substitutions, both coming from Limestone to start the second half. Looks like we're going to have number 9 come in for number 16. That's going to be Angelo Fericio coming in for Mark Radoki. And here come the Crusaders, trying to muster up any sort of offense. The ball is cleared away and once again taken by the Saints. And we've seen a lot of that in the first half. North Greenville just clearing the ball out of bounds. You'd like to see them try and just connect a couple of passes there and maybe, you know, embrace the pressure. They've been unable to do so. And back comes Limestone. Can anyone get on the end of the cross? Yes. It was an excellent cross. Angelo Fabricio just saved by the keeper. It was very accurate. Bottom right corner just didn't quite have enough pace. And North Greenville survives another scare. It's going to go back to Vandermeer, and North Greenville looking to just connect anything here in the midfield, and Limestone just extremely disruptive, just all over the pitch. And once again, nothing doing for North Greenville as they're going to force to pass it back to their central defender. That's number 3, Cade McLaughlin. And here we go. The Saints on the attack. They find another shot on target. It's a terrific save by Vandermeer. And he has kept them in this ball game. That's his 5th save of the game. The Saints definitely didn't make it easy on him on that shot. We're going to get another corner from the Saints. It is whipped in with pace. The header also with pace. However, it is just above the crossbar and nothing doing for Limestone as we're going to get another kick from Reno Vandermeer. That last shot by number 7, Tristan DeLaff. He's had a handful of opportunities in this game. None better than that last one right there, however. Again, the ball is picked away by the Saints in the midfield. North Greenville just unable to get any control. Most of their success coming on the counterattack with their speedster, Semedo. And here comes Limestone, again, back in possession. You feel like just one more goal would sort of seal it the way North Greenville's offense has just been unable to produce. And maybe that's just the strategy for Limestone. They'll just continue to push until they get that second goal and they get more of a comfortable lead. But they still have to be very wary of North Greenville's counterattacking speed. It's been just a bit of a chippy game. Both teams with six fouls, and there's just one yellow card in it, and it's awarded to Limestone. Johan Hipper, the goalie for Limestone, still posting a clean sheet. Didn't give up a goal last week against Belmont Abbey. He's not giving up one here. Is there something brewing in the midfield for North Greenville? There is not. It is stolen by Limestone. Switched over to number 9, Fabricio. And a slide from Ferreira. He is unable to come up with possession. Greenville again. Just nothing doing. And here comes more possession from Limestone. Should feel content just holding the ball and sort of killing North Greenville with 1,000 cuts of passes. But they do seem intent on keeping the pressure up. Still holding a fairly high line. And another cross whipped in, no one on the end of it. Looked like that was Angelo Fabricio on the end of it. Just over his head. And at a certain point, North Greenville is going to have to make a decision down one goal. When do they move more players forward? If the game continues to trend this way, you have to feel that North Greenville are just going to have to find different way to generate offense, and if it means putting more pressure or holding a higher line, then that just might be something they have to do. Here's a ball over the top. It's at the feet of Semedo. Can he make a move? Find a cross. Is there anyone on the end of it? No, not quite. But it is deflected right back to a North Greenville offensive player. A little bit of danger there from North Greenville. That's the first time in this half, in this first 10 minutes, that we've seen them in the attacking third. It was played in by Semedo, but just no one able to get a foot on the end of it. This looks like we have another substitution for North Greenville. Lezema is out, and they're going to bring in number 8, Henao Chica. And that last play for North Greenville was actually an offsides, so it would not have mattered anyway if they had a player to put one in the back of the net. North Greenville with the ball. Can they put something together here? Enjoying just a little bit of possession. And it's a risky challenge, and it is going to be a foul. That's going to be Pascal Verba, the guilty party. North Greenville will take it quickly and see if they can't muster up anything. And that's happened several times today where North Greenville is just, the only play for North Greenville has just been clearing. And that's sort of just been the story of this game. How about this Limestone defenders holding such a high line, and they draw another offsides. It's worked out well for them so far, but you have to wonder, all it takes is just one pass and some Mado able to get on the end of it, and you're looking at a 1-1 game. So risky business, risky game that the Saints are playing here. And a ball over the top, massive pass. However, it falls in the hands safely of Vandermeer. And the ball is going to be hoofed back. Can anyone get possession of it? And that seems like something North Greenville can improve on this game, those 50-50 balls and winning those and just settling it rather than just trying to quickly hoof it downfield. Jacob Hancock almost able to find an opportunity there, but nothing doing. Quickly back the other way. That's Dressler with the ball. He tries to find a cross. Nothing doing. That's certainly not the first time we've seen S.J. Dressler, a defender on the attacking side. He's done that several times tonight. It is a little bit of a risk him going forward, but you have to say he has produced and generated a lot of offensive opportunities. And it looks like we have two players down for North Greenville. One seems to be all right, just stretching, and looks like he's going to be okay. He's going to be helped up by a teammate, and he is going to be okay. No trainer needed on that play. Looks like both players are going to be okay. So far after this first third of the second half, North Greenville's really only had one opportunity that ended in an offsides, but it did come. It was created on the feet of Semedo. And it's a through ball right to the feet of Hancock. He whips it in, and Ferreira is unable to steer it home. It was a great pass from Hancock. Ferreira just unable to make a play, and quickly the other way. It's Vandermeer passing all the way downfield to the left winger, Semedo, who elects to possess it. Great defensive play there by Stefan Ruby. He sort of nixed the speed there of Semedo. What kind of play does North Greenville have drawn up? It's definitely a throw that's dangerous. Is there anyone that could get on the end of this, maybe? Standing next to Semedo, that's number 6, Arthur Leary. And it looks like Leary is going to throw it in. Will they try and put one in front of goal? They do not. They take it fairly short. And Semedo trying to get creative. And just bullied by a battalion of Saints defenders. And here comes Cade McLaughlin throwing the ball in back to his defender. That's number 2, Bradley Jennings, who moves the ball into the midfield. Back over to Jennings. Looking for another long ball over the top, and it is met by a Crusader. Semedo Here's a chance. Not quite. Jorge Henao Chica looked like he had a half chance there, was just one dribble away from getting a sight on goal, and it's back with Arthur Leary, who's fouled on the play, and that's going to be a foul on number 8, Pascal Verba. And as you see, Jorge Henao Chica standing over the ball. He steps away, so we'll see who actually takes this one. We'll see if he tries to go for glory or maybe just dump it to a teammate here. In comes the cross. It's too close to the goalkeeper. It's punched away by the goalkeeper, and it is right to the feet of a Crusader who just hoofs it over the crossbar. It was an ambitious effort, one that did not pay off. That's number 31, Santana Arthur, with a shot. And that will result in a goal kick coming from Johan Hipper. North Greenville looked a little bit dangerous there for about 5 minutes or so, but it seemed like the Saints were up to the task of defending it. Here's Jorge, passes over to the top of the field. Back to a defender, that's Bradley Jennings, now over to McLaughlin. And how about the dribbling skill shown off by Arthur Leary? It's a ball played over to the left side just too far. And that is a missed opportunity. That pass, Calvin Semedo open on the left side just too far. And he's pleading with his teammates. Upset about the pass there. And rightfully so. That could have definitely been a dangerous opportunity. How about this now? North Greenville enjoying more possession. It's another foul against Limestone. Number 2, Stefan Ruby. And Leary is going to take this free kick. Taken by Leary. No one in possession of it yet. And we're going to get a whistle from an official, and it looks like we're going to have a foul against number 31. That's Arthur Santana. And Limestone will do well to take a free kick here. 25 minutes left just in it. North Greenville has looked just a little bit more lively offensively, but still haven't been able to put it together. They've certainly enjoyed more possession in this half than they did last half. Is there any room here? No. Again, cleared by Limestone, and you gotta feel that's a pretty good strategy from Limestone. You know, you feel like they got their one goal, they took the lead, they scored. There's no reason for them to feel pressure or want to attack as much as they did in their first half. Again, North Greenville's counterattacking has been the biggest threat to Limestone, so as long as Limestone just possesses the ball, they won't have to worry about counterattacks. Here we go, Limestone in possession. That's Mark Radoki. Gets it kicked away from him, so Limestone will get a corner kick as Radoki takes a second to tie his shoe.
Yeah.
And now taking this kick is going to be Pascal Verba. And it looks like they're going to try and take this one short. That's number 21, Thomas Mueller, the goal scorer, standing right in front of Verba. Let's see what they decide to do. Everybody standing in the way of Vandermeer. Just look at the bodies in the box. Here we go. And it, ambitious. It looked like it was a shot. And Verba came close, but not quite. It didn't need saving. Vandermeer takes a second to survey his options and takes the kick, and it is deflected, unfortunately, right to the feet. Tristan DeLaff. They set up on offense. That's number two, Stefan Ruby. Crosses it in, no one home. An empty cross from Ruby. And a physical collision between what looks like Christopher Holscher and number two, Stefan Ruby. And North Greenville tried to get a little cute there and go quickly, but the play is whistled dead. And they're going to be forced to take this free kick again. Limestone with 15 shots so far compared to just 5 for Greenville. Still anyone's ball game, though. And Greenville, you have to say, do look a little bit more dangerous in the second half, but still nothing to show for it. Limestone in no hurry, as they just have 21 more minutes to milk before they get this win. It's a deep pass all the way to the feet of Radoki. Radoki can't find anybody, so he dumps it off to a teammate. It's crossed in, and an incredible save. It was a great cross from Radoki. Check that. Ortiz was the one that crossed it in. It looked like Fabricio was on the end of it, and it certainly needed saving. That's a great effort from Vandermeer. Just saves it, and it goes off the post. North Greenville still staying alive in this game, but gonna have to generate a little bit more offense. Here come the Saints again on the left side, and it's a reckless challenge. We might see a yellow card here at the top of your screen. That's S.J. Dressler on the ground, shaken up. Yes, we do see a yellow card. We'll see who they give that to. Certainly a physical challenge, and now the Saints are going to have an opportunity here to double their lead. Taking their time with this setup. In comes the cross. Unable to meet a Saints striker. Semedo will take possession. Quickly loses it. It's a through ball. Try to get it to Ortiz, but the whistle is blown. It looked like North Greenville was going to have another opportunity to counterattack. However, the play is whistled dead. And it looks like we're going to have a foul against Semedo. And Pascal Verba will get another chance to cross one in. Verba whips it in. Anyone on the end of it? No. back to Thomas Mueller. Mueller tries to chip one in, and it is offsides. Still a very dangerous play. That last yellow card is going to be awarded to number two, Jennings Bradley. So he now has a yellow card. Has to be a little bit careful. One more of those will see him off. And Semedo comes out with this. Does he have anyone? Fancy footwork. Tries to cross it in. No one on the end of it. It rolls safely to Johan Hipper. Hipper is going to take his time with this one. A long ball played big to the top of the screen. Mark Radoki unable to get a hold of it. It's cleared out of bounds by North Greenville, so Limestone will have an opportunity for a throw-in play here. Let's see if they get creative here at all. It's taken. It's crossed in, looking for DeLaff. It is not there. DeLaff unable to make clean contact with it, and it's going to be kicked away by Reno Van Der Meer. And here comes North Greenville. Is there a chance here? No, not quite. It looked like for a second that the Saints had made a terrible mistake, but they atone for it, and they keep possession. That's Stefan Ruby trying to fight his way to the ball. And he is going to give his team a corner kick. So now if you're North Greenville, you're approaching the final 15 minutes of this game. You got to start to wonder, when are you going to send more players forward? When do you try and sub on more strikers and more goal scorers? Looks like this corner is going to be taken by Verba. Verba whips it in. No one on the end of it. It looked like the ball was at the feet of Ortiz. He's unable to make good contact with it, and it will result in a goal kick. North Greenville in their own third. Excellent pass up front to Semedo, who is met by a collage of defenders. And it's some risky passing from the Saints. And it could see an opportunity here for Greenville as they take over possession here. Oh. And just when you thought Greenville might put something together, that's number 17, Connor Hall, with a bad pass, and Limestone takes over. Connor Hall just hasn't seen the ball at his feet much this second half. This is Arthur Leary. Back to Jorge, who moves it to the top of the screen, right side, just a little bit too far. It was a good idea by Jorge Henao Chica. The ball just sails out of bounds. Just sort of start to wonder, is there any hope of a goal here for North Greenville? Make a couple of substitutions. But Limestone just has to see 15 more minutes out before they are 2-0 to start their season. It's not over yet, but you have to like their chances. And They're going to take their time with this throw-in as time is on their side. And they're going to attack and some speed at the top of your screen here. It is passed back into the middle. Is the shot going to be good? It is saved and it is off the post. The second time we have seen that today, Vandermeer just gets a hand on it and it goes off one of the posts. Excellent opportunity to really just finish North Greenville, but it's just Vandermeer keeps them in it, keeps them alive. His seventh save of the game. Check that, that's his eighth save, which matches his total a week ago. Here's a ball to Semedo. Look at the speed. It's a great tackle from Pascal Verba. The right back is able to mix and foil the speedster on the wing there. That last shot that went off the post was Angelo Fabricio. He's had a couple opportunities here tonight. Just 13 minutes remain. The throw in from Verba. Oh, and a shove coming from number 20. A little bit of frustration shown by Luis Lezama. Lezama there, the guilty party. And this free kick going to be taken by Ferreira. Whipped in. Is anyone on the end of it? No. It goes to Vandermeer. And they look to try to move this ball into the midfield. It's just 12 minutes in it now. And really for me, it's just been that Limestone midfield dominating. And here you see again, forcing another turnover with the pressure. Ball at the feet of Ferreira. Can Ferreira find an angle for a shot? He lofts the ball up, looking for number nine. That's Fabricio. Fabricio dishes it out to a teammate who is unable to find the back of the net. That's Tristan DeLaff with a shot over the bar. Check that. That shot's actually coming from Mark Radoki just high over the bar. And that'll give North Greenville a chance for a throw-in. And it looks like the North Greenville just made a substitution. Christopher Holscher is going to come out, and they're going to put in Ethan Thompson. And a slide is a clean tackle and a great tackle from number six, Arthur Leary. And North Greenville gets possession. And we might have a foul here. And if it is on Limestone, which it looks like it, it's going to be in a very dangerous position. And North Greenville might be able to set something up here. Pascal Verba. The foul. So North Greenville now with 10 minutes to go. They have a great opportunity here. Arthur Santana looks like he's going to be the one taking this free kick. He has Gage Aker to the right of him, short. We'll see if he likes to cross it in or maybe just go short. Well, no, now it looks like Gage Aker is gonna join the rest of the party. It's whipped in. Nothing doing. Johan Hipper makes quick work of it. And now if you're Limestone, this is really where you decide to just batten down the hatches and park the bus. No need to get cute here. Just milk this last 10 minutes and give yourself a 2-0 start to the season. It's wisely cleared away. And how about this? They still maintain possession? No, not quite. It looked dangerous for a second. Antonio Ferreira almost won that foot race. And there again is another foul. A little bit of frustration, you can understand. That's Arthur Leary with the shove. Limestone player shaken up on the play, but you can't help but wonder, is that just a tactic to sort of get this clock moving? Arthur Santana, the guilty party. Ferreira is going to stand over the ball as he waits for his teammates to get in position. And he just kicks it back to a defender. That's Verba. Verba. Not many opportunities for either team in the second half. But really none for North Greenville. They've had moments of possession, but really nothing substantial. They still just have 5 shots compared to 18 from Limestone. So Limestone have to feel as though, you know, they should be up by more than just 1 goal. But impressive play from Vandermeer has kept the damage to a minimum. He may not be happy with giving up a goal, but certainly should be proud of his performance so far. North Greenville now really running out of time. It's not quite desperation time, but they do have to start thinking about moving some players forward, and here comes a through ball. Just got away from him. Number 31, Arthur Santana, just couldn't settle it down. Limestone definitely content taking their time as they see it drip to 7 minutes. Hipper's going to see that this ball goes as far away from him as possible. Here comes Limestone. Do they want to put this game away by scoring another? It's crossed in by Radoki. No one on the end of it, and that's going to give North Greenville a chance to play the long ball. And once again, nothing there. It looks like we have a North Greenville player coming on to the pitch. And the substitution is going to see that Arthur Santana comes off. Let's see who they put on. It looks like that's Fernando Galvo, I believe, number 25. I can't quite make out his number. Here comes North Greenville. Do they have one last opportunity? Again, foiled by that tough midfield. They've just done such a great job of controlling in the second half. midfielders from Limestone just stifling. They've been playing great offensively and defensively. That's definitely what you want to see out of your midfield. You want to see a diverse midfield, and Limestone has shown you that their midfield can certainly do that. They're certainly capable of taking chances, but also dropping back, and you've especially seen it in the second half. Their midfield is just taking the ball away at every opportunity. Just 5 minutes remaining with a free kick. It's cleared away. The foul's going to be awarded to number two, Bradley Jennings. However, the free kick, nothing comes from it. Final 5 minutes. It feels very desperate right now for North Greenville as they keep losing possession. And Limestone, you have to feel, should have put this game away a while ago, but North Greenville defensively is much improved in the second half, not allowing Limestone to penetrate their back four. Free kick taken quickly by Greenville. Very little time remains for the Crusaders. Do they have a last second miracle within them? It's a pass over the top. There is space. Will it travel out of bounds? No. It's crossed inward, and North Greenville is going to get awarded a corner. So just like that, one big time through ball over the top, and North Greenville looked just a little bit dangerous there. They'll want to send as many people up for this corner kick as possible. They take it quickly. Is anyone on the end of it? No. It's punched away by the keeper, Johan Hipper. Back to a North Greenville player. Looks for another cross. Will he whip it in? No. Fakes a cross and has the ball taken from him. This certainly feels like the last chance North Greenville's going to get. Semedo working on the left side. He's double teamed. Met with a double team. Has an open Crusader pass. Splits a double team with a pass. Trying to find a weakness and nothing doing. They're going to have to pass back to their defense. That's Bradley Jennings. He's going to move it over to Cade McLaughlin. The Crusaders, nothing. Nothing doing. Pleading for a foul. They're not going to get it. The ball is going to be hoofed away by Johan Hipper. Is this it for North Greenville? Semedo. Able to draw a foul there, it looked like, but they're taking it quickly. The advantage is certainly played. A chance here, and it's offsides. Before North Greenville could even get the shot off, the flag was raised. That's the third time North Greenville has been caught offsides. Looked like Luis Lozama just strayed about a foot in front of that last defender. And we're officially in 2 minute warning time here for North Greenville. It's now or never. Kicked away by Hipper. And we're going to make a substitution. It looks like they're going to bring on number 26, Eli Huey. And they're going to take out number two, Bradley Jennings, the center back. We'll see if Eli Huey can create a little bit here for Greenville. And it's a good turn from Limestone. They have the ball. Do they have a cross? They do. It is just fluffed by number 10, Antonio Ferreira. Should have, could have done better. But was unable to get away. That would have been the game. Under 90 seconds for Greenville. Will they even see possession again? Verba hoofs it away. Still loose. The Saints are going to draw a foul there. It's Arthur Leary again. He's been playing fairly physical in the second half, trying to urge his teammates on, but getting very little help and a little bit of a frustration foul there. Because now we're going to see a free kick again. Number 10, Antonio Ferreira. Will he take this one, or will it be Pascal Verba? .101 remaining. It's chipped in and nothing doing. And we're going to get another whistle. And it looks like things are getting a little chippy and a little heated down there in the field. The official having to break things up. And we're going to get a stoppage in play. Rightfully so. It looked like Limestone was almost fouling just to stall more time, but the official picked up on it, and they're going to stop the clock. And now, here you see everyone moving forward. 10 players in the attacking third, as Reno Vandermeer is going to stand over this one, try and whip it into play. Just the one goal in it came from Thomas Mueller. It was unassisted. Again, just a reminder, it was deflected off an NGU defender right at the feet of Mueller just seconds before half. You have to wonder what would have happened if North Greenville was able to just keep possession for those last 60 seconds. We could be looking at overtime, but unfortunately, Thomas Mueller, the star of the game so far with the one goal, was able to just find the bottom left of the net. Still just 5 shots for North Greenville. It seems like forever ago since they've had a shot. Vandermeer stands over it. Still waiting for the go-ahead for the officials. It looks like they're having a conversation with the coaches of North Greenville. That last foul on Arthur Leary actually ended up being a yellow card. And how about this? It looks like a red card has actually been issued. That's number 11, Calvin Somedo, the one bright spot of NGU's offense, is sent off. So if North Greenville's going to pull this off, they're going to have to do it with 10 men. Here we go. Vandermeer whips it in. No one on the end of it. Too many blue jerseys. But they do get awarded a throw-in. It's Huey. Nope, Huey leaves it for number 23. That's Gage Aker. He's going to throw it in. Throws it in the full length of the field. No one on the end of it. Very dangerous throw, though. And Limestone have to see these last 20 seconds out. Another throw-in. Is anyone on the end of it? No. It's Leary who got a foot to it, and it was North Greenville's last chance in this game. It came from number 6, Arthur Leary, and it was too far to the right. And that is going to bring an end to tonight's game. The Limestone Saints are going to win this one over the North Greenville Crusaders 1-0. The star of this game is Thomas Mueller. He didn't have a lot of touches, but when the ball came to his feet, he capitalized. He is your only goal scorer here today.
Against Newbury College at 7:30 p.m.
So that'll bring an end to tonight's matchup. We thank you very much for tuning in with us today. Until next time, I'm Benjamin Kramer. Thank you very much.
Until next time, may God bless you at Go Crusaders.